We're going to draw out all possible amide isomers for C4H9NO in this video. How many isomers do you think we will get? Well, stay tuned until the end of this video to find out. Let's begin. A quick recap. Amide consists of a carbonyl group, C double bond O, which is located right next to a nitrogen. Keep in mind that nitrogen makes three bonds, so the nitrogen will have two other bonds aside from the one that's connected to the carbonyl group. If the two bonds on the nitrogen are connected to hydrogens, then we have a primary amide since the nitrogen is connected to one carbon. If we have a carbon connected to one of the bond on the nitrogen, then we have a secondary amide because the nitrogen is connected to two carbons. Lastly, if all the bonds on the nitrogen are connected to carbons, then we have a tertiary amide. In order to make sure that we draw out all possible amide isomers, let's approach this in a systematic manner. We'll start by drawing out all possible primary amides first, followed by secondary, and then lastly the tertiary amides. Starting with the primary amide, we have used one carbon so far. That means we can place the remaining three carbons like this. This will give us a four carbon chain. It's four carbon chain because we can count continuously four carbon in a row. We can also have the primary amide with a shorter carbon chain. Instead of connecting four carbons straight in a row, we can have three carbon chain like this, and then we place the remaining carbon here. Notice that we don't place the extra carbon at the end of the chain like this. The reason we don't do that is because we'll end up with the same structure like we've drawn. See, we ended up with a four carbon chain since we can count four carbons continuously. So keep in mind, whenever we shorten the chain, the extra carbon, please make sure that you don't place it at the end. Filling up the carbons with the remaining hydrogens will give us these structures. Keep in mind that carbon makes four bonds, so just fill up with the appropriate number of hydrogens for each of the carbons. Moving on to the secondary amide. We've already used up two carbons. That means we can place the remaining two carbons like this. This will give us a three carbon chain secondary amide. We can shorten the chain to two carbon chain like this, and then we place the remaining carbon here. This will give us a two carbon chain secondary amide. We can continue shortening the chain further to get a one carbon chain secondary amide. From that structure, we can shorten the carbon chain on the nitrogen to look like this. That will give us another isomer. Filling up the carbons with hydrogens will give us these structures. Moving on to the tertiary amides. We've already used up three carbons. That means we only have one carbon left. So we'll just connect it next to the carbonyl group like this. This will give us a two carbon chain tertiary amide. We can shorten the chain to one carbon chain like this, and then we place the remaining carbon here. This will give us a one carbon chain tertiary amide. When we fill out the structure with the remaining hydrogen, this is what we'll get. Here are all the eight isomers we have drawn for primary, secondary, and tertiary amides, along with their IUPAC nomenclatures. Did you get the same structures? If you're interested in drawing isomers, I'll place the entire playlist at the end of this video. Thanks for watching all the way till the end. Do subscribe, like, and share this video if you find it helpful. It'll help the channel grow, and I'll really appreciate it.